What's up, boys, and welcome back. Today we're doing some stuff to the old 740, and we have quite a few things on the agenda today. I don't know how I will film this, but first we need to put on some auxiliary lights because I think it looks pretty cool, and also I need some more light for the winter drift, you know. So I'm thinking a rally 4, or what you would call it. So we put one light there, 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 and there, and yeah, that's about the plan. I'm also thinking that I should change out the oil in the engine, because that has been done like last year sometime. So I think she's due for an oil change. I'm thinking we change out the distributor cap, because that one I have glued together because it's cracked. And we also have I feel like I'm 12 years old putting this thing in the car. But we have a subwoofer, and this shit I'm going to mount in the most horrible way possible. So stay tuned for that thing. I also want to do something about the e-brake, because the e-brake in this car works really good. Enough for the winter beater, you know. I don't want to put a hydro in this car because the stock e-brake works really good. So I'm just thinking I need to mock up a mechanism for the button, since I want it working as a regular e-brake as well, but then just extend the handle itself, so you know, you can pull it easier. I use the e-brake a lot when I'm twin drifting in the winter with Leo, and it's actually so nice not doing a hydro in your winter car, because that's a lot of work, and just doing this shit instead is so much easier. But yeah, that's about it. The subwoofer also, I should say, this I've had in the shop for quite some time, so I just haven't had any car that I wanted to put it in, but I thought since I have it, I should try and put it in this thing, see if it sounds any better. So yeah, I'm thinking I'll put the camera up here, and I'll be back when the lights are mounted. Nice. Sup boys, long time no see. I just wanted to go through a bit of the changes that I've done since the last clip. And yeah, so the Rally 4 is on. I don't really know what I think of this, but I think this is like a lot more period correct than a light bar. Even though auxiliary lights help, these are like 55 and 80 watts halogen, so they don't really do shit, to be fair, but they do some and look pretty cool, at least to what I think. And I wired in the subwoofer to check if it worked, because I don't have a split for these cables, so I just plugged one in. Seems to work freaking mint, so I'm trying to plug that in right now. Also did an oil change, which was really nice. The old oil is in there right now, so can't see it, but looked pretty shite. I think the oil hadn't been changed in like slightly over a year, so yeah, it was time to do that. The wiring is total horrendous shit, but here I got the relay for the auxiliary lights. Yeah, nothing special there. This is just something I threw together. You have to keep in mind, I don't really care about this car. This is just what I need for the winter, and that's just what we're doing. As I stated, subwoofer was free, and it actually bumps pretty good, boys. So I'm gonna try and plug that in, and I'll keep you updated on what's happening in the shop. It's nice. So yeah, fuck it. I'm basically done with everything. I didn't film shit, but right now we're going out hitting the street, my guys. Sliding in the rain. No welded diff. Gonna be sick, boys.
Oh, shit!
Yo boys, we're back in the shop to check out the mods we have done. So I already shown you the lights. They work kind of good, I guess. These kind of old auxiliary lights don't really give that good light, to be honest. But I think, like, I wanted to have three there in the upper row, but one of them I can't find at all. We had them up there, I just don't know where it went. And it's so weird that I'm missing one. But anyway, I think this looks kind of cool. It's more period correct, I guess. I feel like you want those round kind of lights on your winter cars. Then, now if you have a good e-brake in your Volvo, I would highly suggest doing this. Shit, there's so many cables everywhere. But yeah, so if you have a good e-brake in your car, you can take a rod like this and just bend it and weld it to your e-brake, and when you do that, you have this button which you use to press down, you know, so the e-brake doesn't lock, but this thing will melt when you weld this, so it basically falls out on its own. So you take that away, and yeah, now the brake doesn't lock up. The things that's nice about this is you get a lot more leverage, so it's really easy to use your handbrake. And it's also like, if you're going on sliding, you know, shifting gears and the boop boop, so much easier than grabbing here at a weird angle. Just so much nicer. I'm so happy that this 740 has a good handbrake, as you've seen in the clips before. Yeah, because doing hydro is nicer, but it's so much more work, and I mean, this works so good, I'm really happy with it. And you can also still use this as a regular handbrake, because you have like a threaded rod or whatever in here, if you can see that. If you drag this thing out, the handbrake locks. So if you pull it up again, push in that sort of pin. Now it's not locking, so you can still use it. I don't know, you could come up with some better contraption for locking it, I guess, but this is fine. This is mostly how I run them. So yeah, you can't really hear subwoofers like when you film them on camera like this, but this is what it sounds like either way. So yeah, actually I'm quite surprised it has some nice bass to it, which was nice because this was also free. But now you're probably wondering, how in the redneck tarnation shit have I mounted my subwoofer? And yeah,
We'll get to that. Because
if you know what a 740 looks like in the trunk, you'll know there's like a big space here,
like in between in there, and that's why where I originally wanted to put the subwoofer. Never mind the cables, that's all shit.
But yeah, because I didn't want it to put it here in the rear, because there are some rust holes here and I don't want it to get wet, you know. But it was too large to put there, and if I put it in here it will get pretty wet, I think. So and for some extra bass, I just fucking redneck mounted it right here in the rear, you know. So I have a strap here. Don't worry, this is super tight. I mean, this shit won't go anywhere. Get a lot of good bass in the core. The cable management is impeccable. It's really good. Like professionally mounted shit. And why I did this is because I'm a lazy fuck and I don't really give a shit. I still have some things to do to the 740 to prepare it for winter season, but it's a good start. And with some other small modifications, we should be ready to whip out some sick tandems, my guys. That's about it for the... I wonder what I'm gonna call this. This is like part one of how you set up your winter drifter here in Sweden. Pretty shit, I know. This is the most unprofessional work I've ever done, but works out fine. And I know also most of you guys are going to say, you'll, as you see, these lights stick out further than the bumper. And I know many of you people will say that I will hit shit and hit Leo a bunch and I will destroy these lights. My answer to that is yes, but I don't give a shit. So now you know. These lights actually hit the road. If you do like a real quick initiation, you know, these will actually scrape on the road right now, which is kind of funny. But yeah, I think it looks kind of cool. I don't give a shit. So I basically thought I should tell you guys that, because I know I get hate for that in the comments. And yeah, that's about it. Hope you enjoyed the drifting clips, and the old 740 is getting better every day. So I'll see you boys in the next video. Please leave a thumbs up and a comment if you liked the video. If you disliked it, leave a thumbs down. That was all from me. Patreon, Instagram, right here in the description, boys. You know the deal. Other than that, I just want to wish every one of you a great day. Have a good one, boys. Bye. Yo, I ain't here for the money, I ain't here for the fame. Though it might be nice to own a jet plane, I'ma do it all for you, come on.